أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلاة obligatory prayers حديث of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم حنزلة أسيدي رضي الله عنه narrates that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said the person who guides the five times salat its wudu its prescribed time its proper ruku and sujood while perceiving it to be the right of Allah on him he is forbidden upon fire Musnad Ahmad Abu Qatada radiallahu anhu reported that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, In a hadith Qudsi that Allah azza wa jal has said, Verily, I have enjoined upon your ummah five times salah, and I have taken upon myself an oath that anyone who observes them at their appointed time, I shall admit him into paradise. If anyone does not offer them regularly, there is no such guarantee from me for him. I may punish him or forgive him. Abu Dawud. Usman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, He who believes that salat is the obligatory right of Allah will enter paradise. He who believes that salat is the obligatory right of Allah will enter paradise. Musnad Ahmad Abu Yala Bazar Majma'u Zawaid. Abdullah bin Qurt radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, On the day of judgment, the first thing a slave of Allah will be held accountable for is salah. If it is found sound and satisfactory, the rest of his deeds will also be sound. And in satisfactory, if found corrupt and rotten, then the rest of his deeds will be corrupt and rotten. Tabrani, Targhib. Jabir radiallahu anhu narrates that a man said to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Verily, so and so offers salah, then at the break of the dawn he steals. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Shortly his salah will prevent him from that sin. Bazar Majma'u Zabaid. Salman radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Verily a Muslim, when he performs wudu, and performs it excellently, then offers the five times salah, his sins are shed just as these leaves shed. Then he recited, and the translation is, and performs salat at the two ends of the day, and in some hours of the night, the five mandatory salat. Verily good deeds remove evil deeds. This is a reminder, meaning advice, for the mindful, those who accept advice. Surah Hud. Chapter 11, verse 114. Musnad Ahmad. Note, according to some scholars, two end means two parts. The first part stands for Fajr Salat and the second part for Zuhr and Asr Salat. Performing Salat in some hours of the night stands for Maghrib and Isha Salat. Tafsir Ibn Kasir. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, The five times salat and the prayer of Friday to Friday and the fasting of Ramadan to Ramadan are atonement for sins that have been committed between them, provided the sinner avoids major sins. Muslim. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, He who guards the obligatory salat will not be written amongst the neglectful. He who guards the obligatory salat will not be written amongst the neglectful. Ibn Khuzaimah. Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhuma narrates that one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned salat and said, For him who remains mindful of his salat, it will be a light and an argument in favor and a means of his salvation on the day of judgment. And for him who is not mindful of his salat, There shall be neither a light nor an argument in his favor, nor a means for his salvation. And on the day of judgment, he will be with Fir'aun, Haman, and Ubay bin Khalf. Musnad Ahmad, Tabrani, Majma'u Zawaid. Note, Fir'aun was the king of Egypt at the time of Musa alayhi salam. Haman was his minister, and Ubay bin Khalf was an ardent idolater an adversary of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Malik al-Ashja'i narrates that his father radiallahu anhu, who said that whenever a man accepted Islam during the time of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, The Sahaba used to teach him Salah, Tabrani. Abu Umama radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked, O Rasulullah, at what time is dua the most readily listened to and accepted? He replied, the one made during the course of latter part of the night and after the obligatory salah. Tirmidhi. Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu narrates, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, the five times are an atonement for the minor sins committed between them. Then he said, a man goes to work, and between his house and his place of work are five streams. When he reaches his place of work and labors there to the extent that Allah willed, he becomes dirty and sweaty. Then on his way back, he passes by the streams, bathing in all, and this repeated bathing leaves no dirt or sweat on him. Salat is just like that. Whenever someone commits a sin and performs salat, makes dua and asks forgiveness, then he is forgiven for the sins he committed preceding the salat. Bazar, Tabrani, Majma'ul Dawaid. Zaid bin Sabit radiallahu anhu narrates that we were commanded by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam to say after every obligatory salat, Subhanallah, meaning glory be to Allah who is above all faults, 33 times. Alhamdulillah, praise be to Allah, 33 times. And Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, 34 times. One Ansari dreamt that someone asked him, has Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam commanded you to say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, and Allahu Akbar 34 times after every obligatory salah? He, the Ansari, said, yes. The voice in the dream said, make it 25 times each and add with it, La ilaha illallah, none is worthy of worship but Allah, 25 times. In the morning, when he went and narrated his dream to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet said, do so. Tirmidhi. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that once some poor immigrants came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and said, the rich have attained the highest ranks and eternal bounties of Allah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, how's that? They replied, they offer salat like we offer salat, and they fast like we fast, and they give charity, and we cannot give charity. And they set slaves free, and we cannot set slaves free. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, should I not teach you something through which you would join those who surpassed you, and keep ahead of those who are after you? And nobody can be better than you unless he also does the same. The Sahaba said, do tell us. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, recite Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, and Allahu Akbar 33 times each after every obligatory salah. Abu Saleh said, the poor immigrants returned to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and said, our rich brothers have heard what we did and have done the same. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam then said, this is Allah's blessing which he bestows to whosoever he wills. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, he who recites Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, and Allahu Akbar 33 times, which makes a total of 99 times, and then recites once the following to complete 100, his sins will be forgiven even if they are as much as the foam of the sea. La ilaha illallahu wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. None is worthy of worship but Allah. He is one. He has no partner. His is the kingdom and for him is all the praise. And he has the power over all things. Muslim. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, subhanaka rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salamun alal mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, birahmatika ya arhamar rahimeen, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah.